not the end of the world at all.
Do you guys have any other concerns or any other queries that you might have about going to university or TAFE or higher education?
Cost too much.
Cost too much. Excellent. I might have all this one to Amy, actually. That's all right.
Okay, so there is a lot of financial support out there for people that want to go and study at uni or at TAFE. I actually have two different scholarships. My first scholarship is from the NT government, and it's an awesome one. It's probably my favourite. It flies me home twice a year. So I have to live in Adelaide to study for 2 years. So twice a year, the government will give me the money to fly up. And you can fly out to wherever you're from. So they fly me to Darwin, but they can fly you to Alice Springs. They can fly you out to Gove. They can fly you to other communities as well. The other scholarship I have is purely because I'm from a rural area. I'm from Darwin, and I'm considered rural. So you guys are considered rural out here as well. And that scholarship gives me $10,000 a year, tax-free. And they pay that to me fortnightly. So there's definitely the financial support out there if you want to go on.
And uni costs a lot though.
Okay, I might talk a little bit about what I'm doing. I'm currently working and studying at the same time. It's a bit weird. As a paramedic, I can get a full-time wage, and I have the highest starting, or my profession has the highest starting graduate salary out of all these guys. When I come out, I think I earn about $65,000 a year. And this is with a qualification as well. But there's nothing wrong with doing something else and coming into a health career afterwards. I think, Jerry, actually, if I could handle this one to you about your experiences.
Well, just to give a quick rundown, which is many years of my past, I've been everything from funeral director, as someone mentioned before. I've worked on the railways, on the running trains, and I've also been a prison officer for the last 18 years. So I've done a lot of jobs and a lot of things before coming to uni. As I said, prison officer, we had to go through a training school as such, not quite a full apprenticeship, but it's still a training school. Come out and thought I was in excellent money. I've now stepped down money a bit to come across as nursing, but I'm now following something I want. So it never really matters. You want to become a motor mechanic, go right ahead, become a motor mechanic. A few years later, you might decide, hey, I want to become a doctor, go and do it. And including once you get into uni and any of the higher education places, the people you meet, like this group we're travelling at the moment, as you said, we're from all over Australia. Tamara and I met last year at a conference, and that was where were we? Aubrey Wodonga. It was the first conference we went to. We met up again, we all went to Tasmania. How long ago is that? 4 weeks?
4 weeks.
4 weeks, something like that. And of course, now I'm here travelling around talking to you lot. So university's not all that, don't get me wrong, it is hard, there's a lot of hard work to do, but the same as any school, you've got to put the effort in. But it's not all just sitting in a dark room.
So what we're going to do is we're going to split up into little groups, get a little bit more hands-on. There's a lot of tools about trades. I think there's different things going to have to be happening. So we'll do that for a little while, and then we'll come back in as a big group in about half an hour's time. So if you want to just split yourselves off into little groups, into little corners, and we'll take you through some of our...
Between going to the different schools and stuff, is just to not expect anything from them and not... I suppose stereotype them themselves and expect that they're all going to be the same, which I think we did really, really well. I think we judged our audiences really well. But I think that's the biggest thing I've learned. And it's exhausting. It's really exhausting, not so much physically, but I found it's really exhausting emotionally. Some of the things we've seen are quite confronting as far as the differences in opportunities between somebody growing up in somebody growing up out here. But apart from that, it's been an amazing, even that part, you know, it's been an amazing trip. Learnt a load. Don't know if I gave as much as I took, but...
Yeah, I think the main thing was I kind of thought that all the schools were going to be really similar, but each one was completely different, so it was good that we were able to be really flexible with the program. Like, that's one of the most important things, I think. I really enjoyed it.
And next year, bring plastering stuff.
Yeah, I really like the plastering. The plastering's the best. And you're the most popular.
As much as there was some hesitation about, standing up in front of these kids and performing, when push came to shove and it actually came time to talk, you delivered beautifully. Like, I don't think anyone would have thought that you were nervous at the time. So, and kids really pick up on that, and I think they thought we were all full of confidence. And it was really great that, it's good that we've all come from NRT because it's all fresh in our mind how much teamwork is so important and how much it still needs to be built on. And it's great if we're fostering in these kids' minds right now how important teamwork is, hopefully, as they enter their health professions, if that's what they try to do, that will continue over. And it'll give a new group of NRC attendees with a passion for multidisciplinary study and work. Obviously, a huge, huge thank you to Melly and to GPPHCNT for making all this possible and all the other people that finance and support the program. I can't say often enough how much I appreciate the opportunity to come out here and the fact that this time I've been able to drag my family along as well to give them a taste of what it was I enjoyed so much last year, and we'll be able to share this together at home, which will be special. And I've now got a new group of students that I can say I've shared an experience with. Alright, say bye to Uluru.
Bye bye, Rock.
Bye-bye.
Everybody's looking for that something. One thing makes it all complete. You find it in strangest places, places you never knew it could be. Some find it in the face of their children. Some find it in the lover's eyes. Who can deny the joy it brings? You found that special thing. You're flying without wings.
Some find a chair in every morning. Some in their solitary lives. And you find it in the works of others. A simple line can make you laugh or cry. You find it in the deepest friendship, the kind you cherish. Much that means you found that special thing. You're flying without wings. So impossible as they may seem, you've got to fight for every dream. 'Cause who's to know which one of you
sunrise on your face,
on your face,
to know that I can't say I love you in any given time or place.
Oh yeah, and it's little things that only I know. Those are the things that make you mine. And it's like flying without wings. You're my special thing. I'm flying without wings. Yes, I am.
And you're the place my life begins. And you'll be where it ends.
I'm flying without wings. And that's the joy you bring. I'm flying without wings.